Okay, so today is all about Bella and my experience with fostering a dog for the first time. Why am I doing this? Why suddenly? I really didn't think about it. I didn't plan it at all. It just happened. I wanted to share my experience with you all because I know how hesitant I was in the beginning to actually do it. Even when I was asked, can you foster her? I took 2 days to decide if I could, and I don't know why, because I was mainly very reluctant to, I didn't know if I'd be able to take care of her. And I think that's mostly what all of us go through. We really don't know if we can live up to the responsibility of taking care of another being, be it a human being or an animal or whatever. But it's been easy. It's actually not been that tough. Although Bella has had a few complications. She was neutered 5 days ago, and when she underwent the operation, she was a few days pregnant. So it's more like an abortion, but she's doing better. I can't wait to show you guys. Bella, come here. Come here, baby. Come here. Bells, come here. Come here, come here, come here. Come here. She's so quiet today. Hi. Hi. Hi, Bellu. She's so timid and she's so polite and she's just so soft. Look at her eyes, guys. Like, just look at those eyes. Bellu. Hi, my Bellu. Hi, my Patta. So you know what happened? Here's her little surgery. They've shaved it off and come here. Every time I go close to her, she lifts her leg up. Come here, come here, come here. Could you? So that's that. You know what she did? So, okay, there are a lot of things that first-time foster parents need to know. You need to keep the cone on 24/7. If you don't, you're just gonna have to like keep your eyes on her 24/7, on them 24/7. I was feeling really bad to do it, so I would take it off, but there were instances where she would just pull on the plaster and just, I don't know, just do everything, and I would shout and I'd take the cone out and put it on her head, and it was just bad. Okay, but it's healed now, so she's fine. But there was one thing that happened day before yesterday. She was, like in her urine, there was also blood, and I didn't know what to do. So I took her to the vet and he gave me antibiotics and Thrombup, which is a dietary supplement, and UT Kid, which is also to prevent any urinary tract infection. Now, Bella is from one of the apartment complexes in Chennai called Metro Zone. And she is going to go back there if she doesn't find a home. And I think I am really hell-bent on finding her a home in Chennai. And I request everyone, like, you know what, like, she is the cutest. She is so docile. She is so sweet. The thing with her is she's about 10 months old. I'm not too sure how many months old yet, but she's a little older, and she doesn't know leash behavior, and even like training her to sit and training her to be patient and calm when food is around is something that I am working on. But I don't want her to get too used to her home, because I'm scared if I don't find her another home. And I know I shouldn't think that way. I know I should be positive and hope that I can find her a home. But it's going to be tough. It's definitely not going to be easy. I'm not going to stop. Okay, so there are a few questions that I wanted to answer for, like, you know, when for first-time foster parents. For main thing is it difficult? No, it's actually not difficult. You will have friends and family around you who will help, who will come up and actually tell you, listen, if you need something, let me know. Okay, I mean, you and I would also do it if one of our friends actually was fostering a pup. So we also have our friends who will do it. And I do have most, everyone's actually coming home to just see her, you know, everyone's like, oh my God, Bella's at home, I want to come and see her, oh my God, I want to come and see. So so people will be a part of it for sure. I don't think I'll ever be able to adopt a pet yet until and unless, like, I know that I'll be able to take care of them properly, because I think it's a sin if you adopt and don't take care, you know. Okay, so what do you need to know? Main thing is, it's not that difficult, guys. Like, if I can do it, then you definitely can. All you need to make sure is that, you know, see, they can't talk, so you need to make sure they're healthy. You need to make sure that you give them their food on time. In fact, she has got me into a routine that I don't think I would ever put myself into. I wake up in the morning and I'm like, okay, Bella's food. And then I'm like, okay, Bella, like, I go and I actually check on her urine. I check what it's like. Is it too red? Is it, because she's still bleeding. So all of that has to be done. And then she still doesn't know, like, where to poop and where to pee and stuff like that. So she's peed all my mats in the house. Yes, it is a task to clean it up. When the maid's not around, I do it myself. But it's all right. It's really okay. It's just that one thing. She is the cutest. Like, when you see this face, I mean, like, come on. Hello, Putu. Hi, my Balu. Why are you looking so sleepy, Balu? She ate nicely. She ate a nice meal. And now she's fast asleep. Look at that cutie. We're going to find her a lovely home. And guys, by lovely home, you need to beat me at it. So what I feed Bella is, because her platelet count is low, and most street dogs, their platelet count will be low because of the ticks that, you know, that they collect and stuff from other street dogs and all of that. So because of that, because her platelet count is low, I have to make sure that it gets better before I send her away. I add radish and beetroot, obviously chicken and rice. That's her main meal. But it's mostly radish, beetroot and liver. So these three things, I give her liver chews. So she chews on it. She chews on some cow hide, like hide and stuff like that. And then, mainly beetroot and radish. And she seems very happy with her meal. And what I do is, I'm not someone who can actually take the pill and stuff it down their mouths and look at them gag and all of that. I cannot bear it. So what I do is, I smash the tablet up, antibiotic, and I put it in the food. I mix it up nicely with her UT kit. That's the UTI syrup and Thrombup, which is her dietary supplement. Mix it up nicely, like, you know, put a little beef in it, put chicken in it, put little garlic. Garlic is apparently really good for their tummy. So if you have a dog at home and you haven't been putting garlic in their food, it's really, really good. Just like how garlic is good for us, it's equally good for dogs. I've learned all this in the last 4 days, guys. I've not known any of this before. So forgive me if I sound like preachy. But I wanted to just share my knowledge with all of y'all, because I know there are many people out there like me who wanted to adopt and want to, like, have a pet at home, but maybe, you know, due to other commitments, it's not possible. Or maybe you live with your family and, you know, it's not just one person's decision. It's a lot of, like, many people's decision when you're living with someone. So I understand that, but I'll tell you what, fostering will give you a lot of happiness that I don't think you would have thought you would have gotten from anything else, because it's just very fulfilling. Today I was talking to a friend and telling them that I do this and this and this and that, and this needs to be done and that needs to be done, and they're telling me that I sounded like a parent. I'm happy. happy that I sounded like a parent, because I want to be a responsible dog mom, you know. That's that. And I can't wait to get Bella home. I'm definitely going to do all that I can, but I will not be sending her anywhere till she is better, till her immunity is better, till she looks and feels her best. I'm a pet parrot. For now. I won't constantly, I mean, maybe. I don't even know if I'm going to do this a lot, because I really like it. One second, guys. My maid is leaving. I need to say bye. Bye, Bulaka. She's the one who, like, helps me take care of Bella. Bulaka, hi. Solunga ellarkum.
Hi.
Bye. Bye, bye. Yeah, so she helps me clean up after Belle's. And Belle's out. Come here. Bellu. So there's one thing I realized about her. She's pretty, she gets attached pretty easily, you know. The other day, come here. Come here, my Bellu. Come here. She's going away. Bellu. Bella. Bella star. What happened, my baby girl? So every time I go next to her, okay, it's damn cute. She'll just lift her. Anyone who goes next to her, she'll just lift her leg up and she'll be like, pet me. Look. Okay, I hope she does it now. Don't embarrass me, okay, Bells? Bells. Okay, she's out to embarrass me only. Shit. But she's the cutest. I think she's a little shy, guys. I really think she's a little shy. Can you see me? My Bellu, what happened, my baby? So I feel like she's still very, very weak, and she has to gain a lot of not just weight but energy and everything else. So we're on that path. Also, what I wanted to tell everyone is that, like I said, you know, you have people who will help you when you're doing something like this. A lot of friends who would come forward and say, let's do something together. So I've come up with a list of in Chennai, okay, this is everything for Chennai. So I've come up with a list of pages that you could people that you could probably seek help from in terms of adoption and fostering and everything. One is I Adopt, and they all have Instagram pages. One is I Adopt, the other one is Besant Memorial Animal Dispensary, and Dogs of Madras. And the Pound. The Pound has been around for a really, really long time. I know them since I was in school or something. So, So, I Adopt, Besant Memorial Animal Dispensary, Dogs of Madras, and the Pound. I am definitely going to be approaching these people for the adoption of Bella once she gets better. And if any of you have any more questions or anything else to say about fostering, then please go ahead and ask me or tell me. I hope that, you know, this has encouraged a lot of y'all to actually get a pet, adopt a pet, for all it's worth, trust me. There's another story I wanted to share with y'all, just to tell you the different kinds of people in and around us. I'm sure all of y'all know that, but just about a lane away from me, there is another little stray called Snow. She's the cutest. You've probably seen her on my stories, she has EPI, so digestion is an issue for her. And so the people who have rescued her have taken her and tied her in the parking lot. Now on first, when you go and see it for the first time and you see this whole thing, you're like, oh my god, how could someone do something like this? Like, you can't tie a dog up the whole day and just let it be fine, you know. You have to do something about it. So when we asked the people who had done this, they had said, see, she has EPI and she can't go on to the roads because she hasn't been neutered yet. It's so important to get the stray dogs neutered, guys. Like, it's utmost important, you know, because that's just going to lead to even more problems. So she couldn't be neutered because she had EPI. So she had to be treated for EPI and then get neutered. So she is undergoing treatment with a doctor that's close by as well, Dr. Priya. And so a lot of people who've seen this happen have been very like worried for the dog. But when I spoke to the owners, the boy's name is Aditya. When I spoke to him, he said she's been treated and the only reason we're tying her is because we have a dog at home. We can't take her up and neither do we want her to go onto the roads and get impregnated, you know. So the only thing for them to do is probably keep her there because there's no one who's come forward to help. And the only help that anyone can do is adopt her. So, guys, if no one can adopt and no one's willing to adopt, then I don't think anyone should have a problem with what these people are doing. If you have a problem with what they're doing, then I guess you should just go and adopt this puppy or figure out a place to, you know, like you can send her. And yeah, that'll probably solve it. So, that's my two cents on this whole thing. I'm very, very pumped about fostering. I think I'm gonna do this more often. I hope this has encouraged a lot of y'all to also go ahead and foster. It'll be a feather in your hat for sure. The feeling that you get from it is unbelievable. Okay, we'll see you, and I'll leave you with a picture of Bella, but she's sleeping. Baby's sleeping. She's tired. She gets very tired in the evenings, you know. She starts like sleeping. And most of the time she's sleeping around the house. I mean, what else will a dog do, right? But she's so cute. Bellu? Why my Bellu? You should see her when someone comes home, you know. She's like the sweetest thing. She'll just go and she'll jump and she'll play and she'll say hi. And she's just like, she's the cutest. I have everyone coming and saying how cute her eyes are, how pretty her eyes are. I'm sure you guys have also seen it in the pictures. Bellu? Bellu baby? My patu. She's like, get away from me already, please. I want to sleep. You want to sleep? You want to sleep, my patu? Okay, so that's Bella for you guys. I hope you like this. And I will see you guys soon in another live, maybe. Or maybe with another puppy that I'm fostering. Ah! Bye!